My dream is that to play for BFC, to be a good person and to be a great footballer.
My dad and my mom, they wanted to see me as a footballer. I told them that this is my dream.
Keep reminding the players what they have to develop and what really they have challenges to face.
With the help of science, we can figure out how we can make that little bit of difference to make that, you know, a world-class Olympic-level athlete.
We have to keep in aspect not just his physical aspect, also his mental thing, because we have players over here from coming from different corners of India.
सब ऐसे मिलके रहते हैं जैसे भाई जैसे मतलब दिन कैसे चला जाता है कुछ पता नहीं चलता.
Boys, why we do this? What happened last match? What was the opening doing? They didn't want to do anything. They just wanted to see through that your position of the ball is off. In this kind of situations, you know the person or the opponent is going to come closer hard. So try to be alert, move it to the corners, play the ball, move. If you don't learn now, it's the same mistake you do. When the ball is coming from the same side, you want to still play the ball towards the same side where it is crowded up. Move. Put the ball to the open space always. Try to learn to play with pressure, come on. If there is pressing happening with the opponent, try to play nice, keep the ball moving from one side to the other side. Play.
Whatever the first team has the same philosophy, we try to follow the same thing because our aim is to develop players from here, from this academy, to put him to the reserve team as well as the first team. When they reach the reserves as well as the first team, and what the first team coach expects, the reserve team coach expects. So we try to train them in such a way they are prepared to play any kind of the first team expects them to play, a different formation or maybe different positions. So they should be ready to play at least more than 2-3 positions.
Obviously, setting up an academy is very important in terms of running a football club. A football club is not always about just the first team. Academy plays a very, very important role. And the idea behind setting up the academy obviously is for youth development. We want to develop the kids. We believe in player development and player progression. And with the Inspire Institute of Sports, we get that, which is why the academy is set up in Bellary rather than in Bengaluru.
Play easy, guys. I don't want any injuries there. Play easy.
Most of the times, we need to encourage them. That's the way. Even while they are in injury in a certain way, we have two very good equipments. One is called as game ready, which is like in cryotherapy and compression, which is really an expensive equipment. And the other one which we have is a recovery boot, which is, takes care of the entire recovery of the legs, which we generally use post-match. To begin with, a beautiful gym setup over here. Apart from that, recovery aspect, we have the ice bath, we have the saunas over here, so there are many facilities which can be accessed over here, plus the sports science stuff which comprises of isokinetic machines which we use to detect the strength and use to, you know, detect a player if he is more prone to injuries, if there are any discrepancies between the right leg and the left leg which can be detectable in numericals.
Gave it best.
Wonderful. In the last few months we've done a lot of things with them, including you know, isokinetic strength testing on the biodex that we have here. We've done a lot of field-based tests with them as well, basically to identify the strength of the muscle groups during a movement. So you can, on that machine Biodex, you can do different kind of tests. So that is with the vision of making sure that we are working towards an injury prevention program. You know, if I'm going into like more technical details, we find out their conventional ratio, we find out their dynamic ratio, and both of them are going to help us in predicting different things. We can recommend the SNC coach that this is what can be done. So on the basis of how his planning is going on, you know, they are able to recruit more exercises based on that specific muscle group.
And change. Change.
As a footballer, you need a solid leg and a lean upper body. So I'll be working on that in the gym. And in the field, I'll be working on speed drills, reaction drills, you know, agility, quick turns, right, left. This is a massive gym. So I can take everybody at the same time. I can put a, you know, 10, 11 station and I can train at the same time. Since I had worked with the first team, so I know what it takes to be, you know, standard of the first team. Some player with the team, he is not understanding, he needs a special attention. I can call him in the afternoon, I can work personally. If you see, if you take a research under 15, like the amateur level, they get more injuries just because they don't know the techniques of landing, how to tackle, you know, body positioning, checking out the shoulders.
Are you checking shoulder? Are you communicating? Close control, but he's looking around also. He's looking around, so he can see the option.
I try my level best to create the option, then I can score the goal, right? So option, for creating the option is very, very important, okay?
When the player comes from the different state teams, from there I work more with the basics, the foundation, the technical ability. I'm working hard towards that. I'm teaching all the players that if to achieve that level. So presentation, I showed them the videos in the video analysis room. So that's the reason I'm telling you, this kind of infrastructure I never saw anywhere in India. So I want to see that this kind of, then only boys will get, our players will go, get the opportunity to play that level. So everything is there. If you see the gym, if you see the ground infrastructure, if you see the accommodation, if you see the food, we work on their nutrition, we work on their hydration, everything.
Youth development is not where you expect within 1 year or 2 years. It is a record of maybe more than 10 years or maybe 8 years. A player needs to be getting groomed from under 13 to under 18, then going to the reserves. So it's a long process where he plays a very vital role in the academy.
We have the under 9s, under 11s and under 13, which are in Bengaluru, which is like a day academy. Under 15, under 18 is the residential academy. A year back we formed the B team. The idea of forming the B team was we found that the boys who are graduating from the under 18 do not necessarily walk into the first team. So this is something which we feel is important in the pathway.
At BFC, it's not only about winning. It's about, you know, playing good football. We have raised the level so high. We are really looking for such talented players. Even with under 13, what we look for is their technical quality, where they can really make it to the senior team, where they can follow the principles of the senior team. They are all from the reserve team, which has gone to the senior team. They got some AFC games last year. It's really good for me as a head of youth who's working with Carlos, with the senior team, and then I have my reserve team. And then the under 18, under 15, I closely always have a watch of them. If you see in our country, there are a lot of questions why we don't make it to the World Cup and all that stuff. But yes, we are working towards it, you know. It's not a short-term program, it's really a long-term program. We want the players to be really humble and play good football. With another 2-3 years, when you have players coming up from the lower level, you know, technically better players.
So, ye baat aapko hamesha dhyan mein rakhna hai ki you are representing the best team in India. We are the best team in India. Do you agree or no? No Facebook, no Instagram. Keep your phone on it. Focus on the match. Now, why are you here to play football, right?
And also your personal friends, especially girlfriends. Please don't put anything on that, because we have already told them about this. Because that is what, you have not reached one level where you can put all these fancy things on the media. Try to control yourself, keep it personal with you, not on the media where everybody can see. So whoever is still putting it, try to remove it. Keep it simple, whatever you are wearing, BFC, only your profile pic, put it on that. That's more than enough.
It's okay to show off. Right now, none of you have achieved anything. There might be few players who have played for India, but they have not played for the first team. There are many instances where players have played for the national team in the youth level, not played at the senior level. But for that, you have to maintain focus and you have to keep going, keep working hard. How many of you like Dimas Delgado? So at 35 years old, he can still run for 90 minutes and cause problems for the opponent team. Why? How does he care for his body? He does the right exercise, he eats the right food. अगर आप अभी से जंक फूड खाना चालू करोगे, ये करोगे, वो करोगे, तो आपका करियर उतना लंबा नहीं चलता है। आप 27-28 में खत्म हो जाओगे आपका करियर।
lot of people think that you put more and more masalas and spices, the food is going to be tasty. It's absolutely wrong. You have to put in a proper way and proper proportion. That's only how you make the food tasty. Here the food is straightforward. It's all about nutrition and the proper diet. Mostly we stress on the natural thing, like natural herbs, fruits, natural green vegetables and all these things. Initially when we started this institute, there was a little bit of challenge that we have faced. The athletes are from different part of India, like Manipur, UP, Haryana, I mean south. So their food habits and their palate is totally different. So I it's my duty to interact with them so that the likings and dislikings we can understand, and accordingly we can change our menus.
Some of you are not moving. Get involved. 6v2. You have to compulsory make more than 12, 15 passes. Then only you get that confidence of passing, keeping the ball more. Okay?
Football especially, or any other sport, is about decision making. And you can only take the right decisions at the right time when the boys are educated. So we felt that whoever comes into our residential academy, education is compulsory. So we ensure that the boys are educated.
Our boys, not only they should focus on sports, as well as they have to also try to be very good in education, try to take education as well as sports together, because we never know how many of them are going to be really becoming professional footballers. But at least down the lane, if they are trying to pull education and sports together, maybe there are a lot of opportunities they can get into the sports line where they can still be what they love to do.
That's the first moral of the story. That we should not trouble animals.
Second.
And second is, yes, others, please.
Andhavishwas,
we should not be superstitious. Correct?
Education is not about scoring good marks. Education is about their holistic development. They are able to decide what is right and wrong. They are able to take decisions, quick decisions, on field, off field. So education is bringing that holistic development and not teaching them X plus Y equals to this. When this opportunity was offered to me, it was the first thing I took it as, because it was a challenge for me to set up the entire institute. We need to empower athletes, and that's where the holistic development comes. It's not only about scoring marks. None of the teachers are expecting them that, you know, they'll score 80 out of 80. But whatever they are learning along with the education, or informal education, that is more important for us. I am using lots of audio visuals and try to give them lots of examples related to their day-to-day life. Athletes and the kids, when they come up to you and share their personal problems, that, you know what, it gives you that job satisfaction that, you know, you are able to deliver what you are supposed to. So it's really, right now I'm on top of the world if I have to. It's beyond the words. Honestly, it's beyond the words. It's really thrilling.
Go!
Player goes to academy, leaving his family, and they feel lonely there. But it is here, when they come here, they get encouraged, they want to do something. When they see everything, the facility, they want to do, means prove themselves, and we always there to help them. So rather than their coach, I am their friends. I'm their friend. They treat me like that. If they have any problem, they come to me, they talk to me. Same with all the rest of the players. We sit together, we try to sort it out always. During our time, everybody knows that we were not having any goalkeeper coaches, but nowadays it's improving a lot. Sometimes I go for A team also during when they need me as a goalkeeper coach. When I come from there, I see Gurpreet playing, and when I see these guys playing, so I try to put some Gurpreet in them also.
A structure or getting the right people to say, to run the academy in terms of the coaches, etc., is very important, because you need to have coaches with the mindset of developing players. I mean, yes, as an academy, as a youth teams, you want to win. But when the focus is only on winning, then you compromise in the process of your development.
Cisco, one of the two players promoted along with Chencho. Chetri passed the fitness test.
My dream is that to play for BFC, to be a good person and to be a great footballer in India.
My dad and my mom, they wanted to see me as a footballer. They had second thoughts about me staying back when I got selected over here. They didn't want me to go, and then I told them that this is my dream. Even I had second thoughts in the beginning. But then I thought about it, and then there's a good chance for me to prove what I am in football. So I decided, and even they supported me.
A few boys that we had selected from the sub-junior nationals in the under-15 category, which nobody else had scouted, trained with us for 1.5 years, 2 years, and now 3 to 4 of those boys have gone on to represent the India under-16 team in the AFC under-16 Asian Cup.
मेरे पास तो उसे कुछ भी नहीं था. मेरे भैया भी उतना नहीं खेलते. जहाँ भी खेलते थे उनको best player से कुछ मिलता था तो मेरे लिए boot लाके देते थे, मेरे लिए jersey लाके देते थे कि तू practice कर खेल. वो लोग चाहते थे कि उन लोगों को पता था कि ये कुछ ना कुछ करेगा, कुछ खेलेगा, अच्छा ही खेलेगा. और मैं भी थोड़ा प्रॉमिस किया था कि मेरी मम्मी को जैसे भी करके नेशनल खेलूँगा और अच्छा ही खेलूँगा ऐसे बोल के. तो मम्मी को पता चला कि मैं BFC में भी हूँ, बहुत खुश हूँ. अभी तो BFC का हमारा ड्रीम है अंडर-16 का आई लीग चैम्पियन होना. उसके लिए बहुत हार्ड वर्क कर रहे हैं हम लोग, मेहनत भी कर रहे हैं कि आई लीग चैम्पियन होना.
Yeah, the facilities are very good and they help us. Like every time, they won't say no, every time they will help.
Here it's amazing because the environment is different. You never know what may happen tomorrow. You might get injured. So the only plan B is academics.
Yeah, बहुत अच्छा है. अभी इंडिया का तो टॉप ही है ये, मुझे ही पता है, सबको ही पता है कि इंडिया का टॉप लेवल का ही है. और यहाँ पे रहने का अच्छा क्वालिटी, इतना अच्छा प्रैक्टिस, इतना अच्छा ग्राउंड, इतना अच्छा सब फैसिलिटी है खाने पीने के लिए. और मुझे तो पता चला कि यहाँ आके मैं नेशनल में गया तो ये मेरे लिए तो सब कुछ ही. मुझे अभी से हार्डवर्क करना पड़ेगा कि उस लेवल में पहुँचने के लिए. और यहाँ के सर लोग जितना हार्डवर्क कराते हैं बहुत अच्छा, मतलब प्रैक्टिस करने के भी इतना अच्छा लगता है कि सब ऐसे मिल के रहते हैं जैसे भाई जैसे. मतलब दिन कैसे चला जाता है कुछ पता नहीं चलते.
वी आर लाइक ब्रदर्स हियर ओनली, लाइक वी आर वेरी फार फ्रॉम फैमिली, सो वी मेक हियर आवर फैमिली.
जो दोस्त अभी बचपन से बने वो लोग साथ में खेलेंगे तो इतना खुशी तो किसी को नहीं होगा कि साथ साथ ही स्टेप बढ़ के हम लोग गए. और यहाँ तक तो मेरे को डाउट भी लग रहा है कि ये लोग जाएंगे ही जाएंगे.
When they were here in the initial phase, everybody was just in their own group. But now after coming here, it's like, oh no, we all are together and we need to study together and we need to, you know, spend this time together.
When they grow up and they become good players or they become good sportsmen, they will feel, yes, I have crossed the stages, so that's why I have become like this today. And why we are doing it, that they have understood, because they are here for a goal.
And what's different about this academy, it's a very professional setup. Right till down, they actually look after the boys really well. They understand each and every aspect, the little things which are important. And that's why this infrastructure, I believe, is very important for them.
I think it really builds up that environment. You know, when we're talking about research, a part of our long-term project here is also using that data that we've collected with these Indian athletes, because there's very limited research also being published on these Indian athletes. You know, so a part of our project is also using that data and publishing it and, you know, telling the world that these are the physical qualities of the Indian athletes, and it's really building up, and some of it is actually at par with the other international level athletes as well.
So you have to evolve every time, but the larger picture will always be to catch the boys young and ensure that they are put in a program which is conducive for them to develop. And the benefit that we as a club would always want to have is to have a lot of players coming up from our setup to go and represent the first team and later on go on to represent the national team also.
I'm sure within 5 to 10 years, we'll have your homegrown players coming into the senior team.
my role is that to develop the players, to give it to the Kenneth sir, that that in that way only we are going to progress. I want to see that one day, not only on the national level, I want to see that our boys, BFC especially, Bengaluru Football Club's academies boys, to represent the international level.
Because I never expected that the BFC would come up with this kind of a plan, but I'm really happy. But I would expect there would be a lot of clubs coming up to do much better for the youth development. Then only we can give something back to the national team. There would be a lot of players coming into the national team. And that would be a good platform for every young player who is trying to take up as a professional footballer.
Like many people, instead of hiring from other clubs, I want our youth academy players should represent Bengaluru FC. So under 15 should go to Kenneth sir. Kenneth sir should send to Musa. Then they have to go to ultimately to the BFC team, then to the Indian team. So we need to produce Indian world-class footballers, and we have the facility. Just that it takes some time, but for sure we can produce a lot of footballers.
Our most of the players, they within 1 year they represent our national team. So maybe in coming years we'll be the best, I think. And now also we are the best, according to me.
Come on, that's better.